I personally believe music, since the beginning of music, has been something that's very sexual. It has had to do with sex through love. For example, love songs always somehow lead to sex. So music itself has a very close correlation to sex. So when you come to the music business and the industry, it obviously has a lot of it. Usually sex sells the music. But also, I personally believe it's because music has always been correlated to sex since the beginning.
I mean, like, you know, the age-old saying goes, you know, that came from 1960s and 70s, you know, the American media and marketing, you know, one of the top 10 things when you're studying it, they say that sex sells, you know, being sexy, sexiness, appealing to people, skimpy tops and stuff, for some reason it gets people's attention. And then they have another saying, which is any media is good media when you're marketing people. So this becomes a real problem, because if you start to believe that any media is good media and sex sells, then all you're going to be doing is wearing skimpy things and showing your body off and doing stuff online without having any real substance, because you know that it's kind of an easy shortcut to get attention on you. Whether it's positive or negative, you still welcome the attention. And that is the problem that a lot of marketing people are having now. It's like, you want to change your image, but all we've seen of you is skimpy clothes. So, you know, it puts an added pressure on the artist, puts an added pressure on the label. And maybe it doesn't end up being beneficial much.
Why would you have a whole table of food and just have one kind of food? You have to have all different kinds of food. You have to have music that's not necessarily sexual, that might be preaching about maybe politics, or might be educating someone. But you have to have the music that has the sex in it. It's just part of the variety, what you'd want to listen to.
Generally, Fingaba Yemi, we've been singing about love, we've been singing about sex, we've been singing about money. So I generally think that it's about, there are people who want to listen to music whereby it's about love making, or it's about love. There are people who want to listen about different topics, about money, about hustle, about different things. But generally, when it comes to sex, I think it's that kind of topic that normally abantu bachiteka konyo would they attend. They pay attention, a lot of attention when it comes to such topics. I don't know why, but maybe it's that's how humans we are created at some point. So all I can say is that I think sex and love, it's part of music.
These are issues that are Ugandan problems that we need to address. You have 99.99% of the industry who are just going to work. They go home to their wives, full stop. And then you have one or two people dragged into court, and it starts to get a reputation for the whole industry. I'll say again, we're not around here doing A, B, C, D and trying to defile people. Artists don't wake up in the morning thinking about that. We think of how to release good music so that we can feed our kids.
No, you cannot blame everything on the artist. You cannot blame the artist for the moral decay. Why? Because most times, actually, it's the mass that needs this sex appeal in the music. They need it and they ask for it.
I think sex is something that is really, really natural. You get, the only reason why it's full of sex scandals is because we are put out there on TV and people try to know our lives.
Not because I'm singing about a love song or a sex song, it means I'm that kind of person, Mochitegera, because some of us, like, sometimes we in the media, we don't show that we are in relationships or whatsoever. Netu vanava antupafe, but respecting ate abatu samwechi tiwa.
Most times, people aren't even interested in very serious music. People just want to have a good time. They want to watch stuff they're interested in, and we are living in a world that is driven by such things. So you can't blame the artist.
Because we have a big spotlight, people put that on us, and they're even liking it more than politicians. Back in the day, they used to now want to catch a football guy jumping on football boys, you know, doing something weird there, and they wanted to grab a political